coronavirus. Why COVID-19 causes lower fatality rate in Singapore? Being the second country affected by COVID-19 after Wuhan, Singapore has stood out to be remarkably successful in controlling the pandemic with fewer than 30 fatalities until 6th of July 2020. To date, only 2 patients are treated in the intensive care unit out of 208 hospitalized patients. For a few days, the fatalities have remained 26. Such situations has led the Singapore government to progress to second phase of new normal, and some activities in the community have resumed. No restrictions in the public transport, such as MRT and buses, regarding social distancing. All students have started attending schools. People can now dine in at food courts and restaurants, although social distancing measures still apply. Most parks have been open, and people are allowed to sit at benches. The question now is why Singapore has extremely low case fatality rate. I am curious to explore the reason. Someone does not need to be a professor in epidemiology to explain the reasons. Whereas some other countries are still using rapid antibody testing, in addition to PCR swab tests, all tests in Singapore are conducted with PCR, totaling to date to nearly 760,000 tests. Unlike many other countries, which have been targeting only those with overt or serious symptoms, Singapore is testing a lot of people with mild or no symptoms. It has been escalating the testing in the migrant worker dormitories, all staff of nursing homes, teachers, on top of known contact to cases. All visitors to public closed spots to undergo IC and temp scan at shopping centers, supermarkets, food courts, traditional markets, etc. Singapore's remarkable contact tracing, which has in recent weeks been labeled the gold standard of near perfect detection by Harvard epidemiologists. A task force tested in 2009 during the bird flu pandemic and again in 2016 during the Zika outbreak was reassembled by January 2020. For SARS-CoV-19. One clear example in the interagency cooperation was between the contact tracing teams of the Ministry of Health and the Singapore Police Force. All relevant sectors are mobilized to ensure the residents comply with the social distancing measures. Totaling 33 billion Singapore dollars are provided by the government to businesses, workers, and households. Every Singaporean aged 21 and above has received a care and support cash payout of $300, $600, or $900, depending on their income. Singapore has long been known for its strict regulations, such as penalty for smoking in forbidden places, demerit points, and fine in traffic offense. Even bubble gums are not available here. During the pandemic, unless you are exercising outdoors, wearing mask is mandatory. First offender will be fined $300 and second offender $600. Grief penalty for those who breach stay home notice from revocation of permanent residency and employment pass. At least 29 people taken to court over COVID-19 outbreak related offenses. Since circuit breaker started, borders closure has been implemented early. Singapore shuts its doors to tourists and short-term visitors from 24th of March 2020. As of today, arrangement of essential business travel has been done with China only. Singapore was one of the earliest countries to detect and submit a transparent case reporting to both domestic and international stakeholders, swift and decisive interventions to promote or impose social distancing, and frequent and consistent public health communications. All press conferences conducted by the government are coordinated and fully attended by relevant ministers simultaneously. Therefore, the communication to public is clear and not confusing. Community facilities have played a key role in shifting the load away from hospitals, with more than 80% of all patients currently located at these facilities as of May 2nd. These facilities in places like Singapore Expo, Changi Exhibition, are for COVID-19 patients with mild symptoms and lower risk factors. Although there has been a steady decline in community cases since 3 weeks ago, the government is not complacent yet and carefully loosened the social distancing measures to avoid the so-called second wave. This is the best explanation to the low case fatality rate because the denominators in this equation is confirmed cases. Irrespective of the severity of illness, it is a blessing in disguise for Singapore in strengthening the image of its healthcare professionals. Not surprising that the discipline and resilience of Singaporeans stand out in the region. In rough conclusion, these factors are behind the low case fatality rate in Singapore. Thank you for watching.